Hello, I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to Let's Read the Books of Skyrim. Today we'll be reading Proper Lock Design, which I found on a corpse near Steepfall Burrow. And right now I'm standing in the Thalmor Embassy Barracks. Proper Lock Design and Construction by Unknown. I have encountered many thieves whose sole interest in locks is how to open them and thereby pilfer the protected contents of the room or chest. I have taken it upon myself to devise a system of locks that can defeat such villainous intent. The materials used to create a lock are of utmost importance. Shoddy brass or copper will give way to a well-placed kick, thereby rendering the lock itself useless. I recommend steel over iron when choosing a material. More robust materials tend to be prohibitively expensive and necessitate the door being made of similar metals. I have been chagrined to stumble across the shattered shell of a wooden chest, its dwarven lock intact and still locked. Once these basics are settled, pay particular attention to the offset of the tumblers. A 7-degree offset to the keyhole will allow a Torx-style key to work smoothly, while at the same time causing numerous headaches for the thief attempting to insert non-Torx lockpicks. In similar fashion, the springs of the tumblers should be made by different smiths. Each smith will unknowingly create a spring with different tension than his fellow smiths. This variance will also create difficulties for anyone attempting to pick the lock. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Skyrim, Proper Lock Design.